Chiazze, please be seated. Reverend Paul Carr will do the offering prayer for us.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we do thank you, Lord, that we have this opportunity to come together as a church. We thank you for your provision in our lives, Lord, and as we give back some of that provision to you, we ask that you give this church wisdom to use those offerings in a way that pleases you, that encourages faith throughout this community, and makes a change in this world, as we pray that your Son comes back one day and changes the world permanently.
Amen. Today's Bible scripture reading in English and in Mandarin will be Susan. Susan, would you like to do the...
Today's scripture reading taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 1 to 2. Paul, called to be apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and our brother Sosthene, to the church of God in Corinth, to those sanctified in Christ Jesus and called to be holy, together with all those everywhere who call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 22 to 23. And God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. 今天的圣经经文读自《哥林多前书》第一章第一至二节。奉神旨意蒙召做耶稣基督使徒的保罗，同弟兄所提尼写信给在哥林多神的教会。 就是在耶稣基督里成圣，蒙召做圣徒的，以及所在各处求告我主耶稣之名的人。基督是他们的主，也是我们的主。以弗所书第一章第22至23节，神使万有伏在他的脚下，就使他为教会做万有之首。教会是他的身体，是那充满万有者所充满的。May God bless his holy word。愿上帝祝福他的话语。
我只是要用台语来读，咱圣经在头一个所在是哥林多前书一章第一十到第二十。对上帝旨意受吊罪耶稣基督的使徒保罗，甲兄弟所提尼，配寄予上帝教会伫哥林多的时，就是踮伫基督耶稣成圣受吊。 做圣徒以及纪念读所在求咱的主耶稣基督的名的主是因的，也是咱的。咱这第二节的部分是伫以弗所第一章二十二节到二十三节，各乎万行有行服伫伊的脚下，各将伊做管万有的。 万有的头来享受教会，教会是伊的身躯，伊所充满的，伊也是用万有充满万有的。以上，愿上帝祝福，读圣经的。咱只是要请本堂的台语堂教会牧师、牛牧师来跟咱讲到，伊到底伊是什么是教会 ？Reverend Liang is going to give us a sermon on what is the church.
Today, 各位弟兄姊妹，大家平安。 I wish all the brothers and sisters in Christ peace. Let's pray. 请咱三甲做来祈祷，我们一起来祷告。至圣天父，我感谢你恩典，今仔日是你的圣主日，我搁一摆聚集伫你的圣殿，要来敬拜阿罗哩，恳求你的圣神即时甲我三甲伫地，拍开我的心门耳孔，对头到尾，引带束缚即场的敬拜阿罗哩的礼拜。我们在天上父，我们感谢你的恩典。今天是你的圣主日，我们聚集在你的圣殿，我们敬拜赞美你，我们恳求你的圣灵与我们同在，打开我们的心门，打开我们的耳朵，让我们从头到尾有你的引导保守。借着这场礼拜，我们来献上我们的敬拜赞美。Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning's worship here. That we thank you, you've been guiding and leading through our lives. We pray that your Holy Spirit will be with us.Open our hearts, open our ears, so that through this sermon, through this worship, we know how much we can serve you, how much you love us. As we about to start, we pray all this in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
今仔日是父亲节，也是台湾教会设立的这个58周年的纪念日。今天是父亲节，也是台湾教会设立58周年的纪念日。
Today is Father's Day, and it's also the 58th anniversary of Formosan Grace Christian Church in Toronto.
当咱咧庆祝这个两个真重要的节日的时，有两件非常重要的代志。我想咱大家必须爱深深来记牢的，就是咱前辈、咱的先人所留落来的一个遗产，以及因所留落来的一个传统。当我们今天在这里庆祝这两个非常重要的日子，父亲节还有社交纪念日的时候，我想有两件事情非常重要，我们必须要牢记。第一个就是我们的先人他们所留下来的遗产，以及他们所留下来的传统。
As we are celebrating these two very important days, there are two very important things to be remembered. First thing is the legacy. Second is the tradition.From the predecessors.
对老爸还是讲父亲一辈的人传承下来的遗产，包括家训、家庭的教训、信仰、智慧、财物、财产等等，拢必须要珍惜，并且必须要给延续。从我们的父亲或是父辈留下来的这个遗产，包括家训、包括信仰、智慧、知识、财产等等，我们都必须要珍惜，并且必须要把它延续。
The legacy is passed on from our father's generation. For example, family value, faith, belief, wisdom, knowledge, property, etc. We have to cherish and while we pass it on as well.
对咱的信仰前辈因传承下来的这个传统，包括信仰、眼光、目标、方向、人生的价值等等，咱也要遵守并且来发扬。从我们信仰前辈所传承给我们的这个传统，包括我们的信仰，包括我们的眼光、目标、方向、人生价值等等，我们必须要谨守，并且要发扬。
The traditions passed on from our faith predecessors, for example, faith, belief, vision, goal, direction, and value of life, etc. We have to follow and exalt it as well.
那安尼，咱就当无辜负咱的老爸的父辈，吼，也是讲咱的先人以及咱的信仰的前辈，因开设咱的吼一间教会以及创立吼开始咱这个家庭时阵所付出以及因的用心。如此一来，我们才能够真正不辜负我们的父辈以及信仰前辈们开创这个家庭和教会时候他们的付出以及用心。
Thus, we will live up to both our father's generation and the predecessors of faith, with their efforts and hearts when they build up the family and the church before, in the past time.
所以接受下来，我的讲道，我要用华语以及英语来做一个分享，因为有人提议讲，我原本要分享的方式就是讲用台语讲道，用英语来翻译。检测华语堂的人，因听无，所以华语堂的人，因本来想讲要带去边啊一间细间的礼拜堂，底下要有人翻译。总是我个人认为，吼，这款的一个做法
无好势、无适当，特别是伫个今仔日这么重要的一个日子，吼，是一个联合礼拜。所以我想，所有的人拢应该留伫这个所在，咱做伙来敬拜上帝。也就是因为安尼，我才决定讲要做一个改变，就是今仔日咱要用华语以及英语来做一个讲道，然后最后我用台语来做一个重点的一个强调。希望咱大家会当理解，和我今仔日的一个决定以及做法。今仔日咱用另外一个方法，甲咱用另外一个咱。大家都知道，总是不是遐尼啊惯习的一个语言，同款来听上帝的话，以及来听上帝的教示以及启示。这个、表现出咱做一个基督徒，咱的贴心以及包容，愿上帝的听，甲咱每一位三格地带。所以今天我的讲到，考虑之后，我决定用华语跟英语啊、因为第一方面三个语言占据太多的时间。那么为什么要用？华语跟英语呢？因为我们当中有这样子两群好的会众，他们是用这样的语言在敬拜上帝。那我想，我们今天用一个比较不，也许讲台语的人不是很习惯的方的一个语言，但是我们都听得懂的语言，我们改变一下方式，来一样来听神的话语。So okay, I'm going to use both Mandarin and English for my sermon today. It's for the purpose of letting everybody can stay in here and worship God together without, you know, having to move over to the other place to worship God or to listen to the sermon in their own language. Okay. 所以我现在开始我今天的讲道。首先我们来思考一下什么是社群，社会的社，群体的群。英语 有一句话叫做 No man is an island, no man stands alone.人类是群居的生物，没有人可以离群所居。所以群体的生活有什么好处呢？有它可以增加食物的获得。也就是说，我们一群人在这个地方居住，我们出去打猎，古时候，或是我们去耕种，我们都可以获得比较多的这个食物的资源。然后我们可以得到这些资源之后，我们可以分享成果，延续确保生命的一个延续。因为小孩子都会有人顾，那也都会有东西可以吃。然后各司其职，降低这个资源的浪费。因为我们是一个群体，总是有人喜欢这个，有人不喜欢那个，所以大家互相分享，互相的一个配合这样子。第四个是分工合作，可以提高整体的效率。一样，在一个群体，有人比较擅长某些事情，有人比较擅长其他的事情，大家彼此帮忙，彼此协助，所以这样就形成了一个社群。这是社群。那么什么是教会呢？教会是什么呢？在我的印象当中，教会就是你看到一个房子屋顶上面有一个十字架，好，在一个屋顶的上面，这样的一个建筑物。然后呢，有人说是有诗班唱圣歌，然后可以做礼拜的地方。然后星期天有儿童主日学，我可以把我小孩送去那边，去学习一些这个信仰的知识。然后暑假期间也会举办这个叫做夏季学校，让我的孩子有事情可以做。而且呢，在复活节的时候，他们会发一个红蛋，然后圣诞节的时候会发一个圣诞糕，然后这是我过去的一个经验了。So I'm going to start with my sermon of the first question. What is a community? What is a community? There's a saying that no man is an island, no man stands alone. So when you think about when you live in a place by yourself, then sometimes you feel lonely, sometimes you need help, but nobody can help you. So as living as a group life, we can gain something more than living alone, which is that we have more chance of survival. That's the first thing. Second, we can share food. So lives and, and our living can be more better protected. And number three, we work together. It's going to be more efficiency, more efficient, which means that somebody is better in doing something like this, and somebody else is better in doing something else. So everybody can work together and cooperate with each other. And that's number four, cooperation, more success in our living. That is indeed the formation of community, that's so-called the community. And then we have to think about what is the church? From my background, I can think of five things, actually, the features. First thing, when you think about a church, I think you think about a building with a rooftop, there's a cross. Okay, there's no doubt this is church. And then number two is a place for worship, and you can hear the choir singing just like what we did. And then number three, they hold Sunday school programs, so I can send my children over on Sundays to learn some faithful knowledge. And number four, some church might hold a summer school program as well. So my kids have something to do in the summer instead of fooling around, doing nothing. And number five, for Easter, the church will prepare like eggs. You know, sometimes they paint it in red or they wrap it in red paper and distribute to all the kids and to everyone. And that's one thing. The other thing is that during the Christmas time, for my mother's church in Taiwan, they prepare cakes for everybody to enjoy. So that's the features or the content I can think of as a church. 好，我们刚刚讲了社群还有教会。那么我今天要在这里跟大家做一个分享，就是什么是教会。主耶稣说，我要把我的教会建造在这个磐石上，记载在马太福音16章18节。在新约的时代，我们知道在五旬节的时候就是圣灵降临节，那时候圣灵降临在众门徒身上，然后他们受到感动，然后当然会说方言，从此以后教会就在那个时候开始被建立。所以建立在这个地面上，这是教会在新约的时期所建立的时候。然后我们讲到教会的定义是什么呢？我在这里下了一个定义，就是说被上帝救赎，归属基督，同心敬拜，并且以爱彼此交通的基督徒的群体。好，这是教会的一个定义。那么接着我们要思考，那教会还有什么其他的意义呢？第一个，教会是主内的家。为什么这么说？因为它是每一个基督徒心灵归属的地方，没有人就不成家，没有爱也不是家。第二个，教会是基督的身体。在以弗所书5章23节，他这么记载：基督是教会的头，他又是教会全体的救主。第三，教会以信徒做肢体，因为我们刚刚讲，基督是教会的元首，是教会的头，教会是身体，那么我们每一个人当然就是教会这个身体的肢体。哥林多前书12章27节这样记载：你们就是基督的身子，并且各自做肢体。好，第四，教会是圣灵的殿，记载在哥林多前书3章17节，因为神的殿是圣的，这殿就是你们。好，这就是我总括教会的一个实质的一个定义。 Then we have to think about what is the definition or what is the meaning of the church. In Matthew, New Testament, Gospel of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 18, Jesus said, "On this rock I will build my church." So the first church established when disciples were filled with Holy Spirit at Pentecost. Okay, so that's the very first time that the church was built on earth. And then a church, the definition of a church, I put it as this way. A church is a group of Christians redeemed by God, belong to Christ, worship and fellowship with love together. That's the definition of the church I put. So there's also four meanings of church that I would like to share with you. Number one, it's the home of God. It's a place for every Christian's heart. It's a family with members and love. And then number two, it's the body of Christ. As I just said, in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 23, Christ is the head of the church, his body, and he is himself Savior. Its savior. Number three, it's the member of the body. As I mentioned, Christ is the head of the church, and the church is the body of Christ. Then each one of us are the members of the body. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 27, it says, "You are the body of Christ and individually members of it." Number four, the temple of the Holy Spirit. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17, God's temple is holy, and you are that temple. So here we see the meanings, the definition of the church. 所以我们接着要来思考， 如何建立一个教会，教会如何建立，我把它放六个 W， 就是教会是什么 ？What？ 由谁建立 ？Who？ 何时建立 ？When？ 何处建立 ？Where？ 如何建立 ？How？ 以及归属于谁？教会是谁的 ？Whose？ 先看第一个，教会是什么？是一群蒙神呼召、因信耶稣基督而罪得赦免的罪人。教会是一群蒙神呼召、因信耶稣基督而罪得赦免的罪人。所以在这里，我想我们不要认为一直想说来教会都是圣徒，其实刚好相反，来教会都是罪人，包括你我都是罪人。唯一不同的是，我们知道自己是罪人，我们愿意来到神的面前来悔改认罪。那么第二个是由谁建立 ？Who？ 世界上所有的教会都是由主耶稣自己所设立的。第三个，何时建立 ？When？ 从主耶稣呼召他的门徒来跟随他的那一刻开始。所以你可以想象到在那个加利利的湖边，主耶稣呼召他的门徒，那些捕鱼的，包括西门彼得、约翰、雅各等等。第四，在何处建立？耶稣基督他在世界各个角落建立属于他的教会。第五，如何建立 ？How？ 耶稣自己寻找拯救失丧的人，并且用他的宝血洗净他们的罪，使他们与主合而为一，从此来建立了教会。第六，归属于谁？是谁的教会呢？世界上所有奉主名建立的教会都是属于耶稣基督。So next we're going to think about how to build up a church. Here I share with you for six W's. There are what, who, when, where, how, and whose. Number one, what is a church? The definition of a church I just mentioned, and here I mention again, is a group of redeemed people, a group of sinners with calling from God. So keep in mind, before we come to the church, we always think that there are a bunch or a group of people who are saints, they will come to church. But actually, in fact, it's reversed. Actually, most people, almost everyone, including you and me, we're all sinners. The only difference is that we know our sin, so we come to God and we repent our sin. Therefore, God will forgive us, and we are redeemed. So that's number one. What is the church? Number two, who built up the church? Jesus built up every church in the world. We all know about that. And number three, when was the church built up? It's when Jesus called us to follow him. So when Jesus called either you or me or other people, when each one of us, respond to Jesus' calling, that's the time when the church was built. Number four, where to build up the church? Jesus built up his churches everywhere in the world. Number five, how to build up a church? Jesus looked for the lost ones and washed away their sins with his precious blood. Whose church is this? Every church is owned and belongs to Jesus. So therefore, it's very clear that we can see the total definition of the church. 我刚刚忘记跟大家提醒，在我们的周报，其实我已经放上了我这个讲到的一个重点了。好，所以其实都在上面。所以如果我们有机会的话，可以拿起来，再仔细把它看一下，在我们的周报里面。好，接着我要跟大家分享教会的功能。既然它是一个组织，它就是必须有功能，它就是必须有一些法规，有一些规定，我们照着这个规定来行事，来做所有的事情。教会有五大功能，第一个，它有礼拜跟聚会的功能，它可以主日礼拜，可以周间的聚会。第二个是教育跟训练的功能，有信仰的教育，就像透过查经会、主日学，或是星期天主日的讲道。这个我们都可以得到一个信仰的教育，以及在不定时我们会举行这个门徒训练，或是细胞小组，那都是一个训练的课程。第三是团契以及关怀，团契交通包括我们有这个松柏团契、妇女团契，甚至我们会有青年团契，会有那个少年团契、儿童团契，像今天的儿童诗班等等，这是团契的交通。以及关怀就是在于肢体的互相的一个关怀， 平常我牧师我们的这个会友都会彼此之间来联络，看有谁身体不舒服，甚至住院了，甚至要开刀了，或是有谁心里这个心情非常的糟糕，然后心情非常的坏，心里忧伤的，我们也透过彼此的关怀来安慰他们。第四点是这个侍奉还有服务，侍奉就包括属灵的侍奉，教会一切所做的都是属于这个属灵的侍奉，以及服务呢，其实是针对我们过去讲社区，但是不一定每个教会它所处的这个地方旁边都会有人居住，有社区，就像我们教会，我们是一个以前是一个工业区的地方，所以我把它改成社群 community。社群的服务，这个社群的服务就不一定是在你家隔壁，在教会的隔壁，而是一种投射状的。比如说，它是另外的一个社团组织，跟我们的教会、跟我们的民族有相关的，我们这个也可以 outreach， 把我们的触角伸到他们那边去。第五就是传道，还有宣教。传道当然是指传扬福音，那么宣教就是引人归主。我想这个就是教会的五大功能。And the next we are talking about.We are going to talk about the functions of a church. I make five major functions of a church. Number one is a Sunday worship or gatherings. It's a place for gatherings to have meetings, to have gathering, Bible study, prayer meetings, or even our Sunday worship. And number two is the education and discipleship training. Number three is for fellowship, including caring and networking.And number four is devotion and serving the community. Number five, evangelism and the Great Commission. 所以照这样来看，我们可以得到以下的结论：不同的人他对教会有不同的看法。将教会视为是家庭的人，他注重的是什么？这个教会应该要讲恩典、宽恕、慈爱，因为家庭就是讲这些东西：恩典、宽恕和慈爱。另外一种人将教会看作是身体，基督的身体，就讲关系、连结、合一。好，这是将教会视为身体的人，他对于教会的看法是讲关系、讲连结、讲合一。第三种将教会视为是圣殿的人，他会着重在圣洁、体制还有侍奉上面。好，因为它是一个圣殿，是上帝的殿，所以当然要圣洁，当然我们有规则，我们有体制，然后我们会讲侍奉神。So my conclusion come to what are we regarding church as? What do you think a church is? There are basically three types of people who thinking the meaning of a church. Number one, they regarding church as a family. So for this group of people, they regarding church as a family, they will emphasize on grace.Forgiveness and love. That's the first type. Second type, they regarding church as a body. Then for them, relationships, connections, and unity is most important. Then for third group of people, they regard church as the holy temple. Then they will emphasize on holiness, on system, the regulations, and devotion. So you can see one church, but from three different group of people's point of view,You can see, they see church as family, as body, as the holy temple. They will have different kind of conception, concept of the church. So everybody's right. Nobody is wrong. It's just that they have different perspective and different point of view. That's all. So when we're talking about what is the meaning of the church,I wish you, I hope that you can read through what I put in a bulletin. That's everything I've mentioned today. I hope that this will be helpful for you to understand the real meaning of the church. There are scriptures involved as well. 所以我刚刚跟大家讲过一次，在我们的周报里面，我把我今天讲到的重点放在这里，里面有圣经章节，有我刚刚跟大家分享的内容，就是透过这样让大家再去思考教会的意义到底是什么？教会是什么？那我们应该从哪一个角度去看神的教会？我想这样子的话，我们就对于这个由罪人所组成的一个组织、一个团体有更深入的一个了解，然后我们也可以彼此的接纳、包容，去了解对方。So as long as we can understand as I just mentioned, three different groups of people, they have three different kind of point of view and perspective about the meaning of the church. Then we can, you know, start to learn to understand each other's thought and each other's point of view, so that we can learn to accepting, you know, each other's ideas or suggestions or even their thoughts, etc. So that eventually we can, you know, unify in the Christ, in Christ. 所以最后，我们就能够达到在主内合一的一个目的。好，最后我要跟大家分享一段圣经节，就是记载在这个以弗所书第四章十五节到十六节的地方。唯用爱心说诚实话，凡事长进，连于元首基督，全身都靠他联络得合适，百节各按各职，照着身体的功能彼此相助，便叫身体渐渐增长，在爱中建立自己。Okay, last, I would like to share with you a scripture from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 15 to 16. Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into Him, into Christ, who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and held together by every joint with which is equipped, with each part is working properly, makes the body grow so that it builds itself up in love. 最后我跟大家分享这个《以弗所书》第四章第十五节到十六节的所在，是踮伫人内讲话真实，予咱伫万行渐渐大，到伫迄个最头的，就是基督。对伫伊全身结合联络，就是对百节的三接应，照伫体该人的运动，照特体该人的运动。地到身躯哪中大，伫人内家己起造。所以我今仔日甲大家所分享这个内容，虽然是用华语甲英语，我想咱讲华语啊，讲这个台语的这个兄弟姐妹，咱也是听有。我最后阁简单将这个重点用台语阁解，吼，阁甲大家 review 一下。主要所讲，我要将我的教会起造伫这个石盘顶面。教会定义是甚物？就是上帝和上帝救赎。属地基督，同心敬拜，彼此交通的基督徒的一个群体，是主内的家，是基督的身躯，是信徒最基体，是圣神的殿。教会是甚么？是一群和上帝呼召，因为信耶稣基督，做得到赦免的罪人。和甚么人建立？世界所有奉主名去做教会，拢是主耶稣家己所设立的。当时来。建立教会，对主要所呼召门徒来军队伊的迄一刻开始，啥时啊？什么所在来起造来建立？就是主要所伫世界大角落来起造伊的教会，怎样来建立？主要所敲锤遐失丧啊，拯救因哦失丧的人，并且用伊的宝血来洗清因的罪恶，和因甲主搁一摆合一来起造教会。然后教会是甚么人的？记呐。在世界上，既然奉主的名所建立的教会，拢是属于主耶稣基督。然后最后我讲到教会五个功能，就是礼拜聚会，第一个、第二教育训练，第三团契关怀，第四侍奉服务，第五传道以及宣告。这是我今天要跟大家分享的关于什么是教会的所有内容。愿上帝帮助，愿神帮助我们每一个人，透过他的话语。来真正去了解到教会真实的意义，使我们真正能够在主里合一，真正成为主内的弟兄姐妹。So that's everything I would like to share with you today about the meaning of what is a church. Through the sharing of God's word, I'm hoping that each one of us can learn to understand the real meaning of the church so that we can learn to accepting each other, learn to serve each other, so eventually we can be united, be unified in Christ. So let's pray all together. 让我们一同来低头祷告。至圣天父，我感谢你，搁一摆伫你的圣主日，我受阮的家己伫今仔即个特别的日子父亲节，我的教会设教的纪念日，我三甲伫只敬拜俄罗斯。主啊，通过今仔日的分享，我学习什么是教会，我学习。要做一个基督徒，阮就怎样来伫你面前认罪悔改？阮就怎样来接纳吼彼此用疼来对待，来三款待彼此来协助，来互相勉励，来真正伫你内面合作一体。 困苦里帮掌管。亲爱的主耶稣，我们感谢你的恩典，再一次我们在你的主日、来到圣殿敬拜赞美你。今天特别是父亲节以及我们教会设立的纪念日，我们恳求你的圣灵、与我们同在，让我们今天的这个崇拜礼拜向我们献上的祭，将这个香味飘到你的面前，也恳求你借着我们今天的分享，什么是教会的意义，我们学习彼此接纳，彼此相爱，我们学习在你的里面互相了解，互相劝勉，在你主里面合而为一，让我们学习在你的面前我们认罪悔改，成为 新造的人，得到主你的悦纳。 Our Heavenly Father, we thank you again for today, both our Father's Day and our anniversary of our church. We thank you that you send your Son Jesus Christ to this world to save us, wash off our sins and redeem us. We pray that you keep leading us and guiding us. And through today's sharing of the sermon, what is the church? The meaning, so that we can learn to accepting each other's difference, to love one another, and also to understand one another and be united in Christ your name, so that we can be real so-called brothers and sisters in Christ. We thank you again for today's service, and we may all the glories be unto you and be beneficial to everyone around us. We pray all this in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.